Any other parts of the lock?
All right. This is called the shackle. Okay. It's the part that actually moves around the object. This is the lock's body. The square part. Inside of the body, there's two parts. Does anybody know either of those two parts? So there's the tumbler, which locks into that notch of the shackle, and that's actually what holds the shackle down. It's called a tumbler. Then there's pins on the inside, and that's actually what the key manipulates. Each of those notches manipulates a pin differently, and that's how you get the key to unlock the lock. In forceful entry, you're trying to defeat the weakest part, right? So on this dollar store lock, it actually costs $1.25, the captain was saying, is probably the weakest part, right? It's not going to be the welded shackle on the side of the shipping container. Now, when you get into those magnetic locks or the round locks that like go on storage units or like those super heavy duty beefy locks, that might not be the weakest part of the system, right? Because if you have one of those locks on the side of a shed and all that's holding it on is one of those sheet metal shackles and a couple screws into wood, that might be easier to defeat than the lock. Let's say you do get into one of those heavy duty locks that either magnetic or high security locks, and it's on a building like this with a heavy duty door and a steel frame and brick construction, and it turns out that the lock is going to be the weakest part of the system and you have to defeat it. What are some ideas other than a set of irons that we're going to use today that you could use to defeat a heavy-duty, high-security lock?
If it's power, we can power.
Yep. A lot of lock in the lock position.
If it's a heavy-duty lock, are you saying?
Yep, like heavy-duty, beefy, high-security lock. Perfect, K-12. What do you got?
Clippers.
Okay, yep, bolt cutters might not. A K-12 will definitely get through it at some point. So high security locks, you got to get through it. That might be the best bet, right? We're going to go over to the shipping container, and we're going to use a set of irons to defeat a simple padlock like this, all right?
Ooh, that's a lock.
What?
I go between you guys. Ooh, is that a lock of talk?
Little block sash?
A little block sash.
Let me go ahead and grab the irons.
Is this a one person job or two?
Two. Right. So, what you're going to do. You're going to take the pike of that halligan, put the pike of the halligan between the shackle and the lock body. So the best way to hit it, because if you hit like this, it's going to slide, right? Mm-hmm. So the best way is vertical as you can get it, because then you're just going to shear that tumbler on the inside. This is what you might run into, where you're not able to get the pike of the halligan in there very good. You're not able to get it to be vertical. So you might have to kind of attack this lock in a couple steps. So you might have to just get the pike of the halligan in there, have your partner strike, get a little more room in there, and then kind of bend it vertically to shear it off, right? So. It'll break eventually. There you go. You gotta be louder when you're calling for the hits. Go ahead and just drop them on the ground if you want, or hang on to them. Thank you. So, well, hold on. You're gonna apply force like this, right? It's gonna always move on you. So, you might have to move your hand up a little bit, have a little better manipulating ability. Here. Now, see if you can kind of hold it like that.
Right.
What's something else to keep going? What's something else to consider when you're forcing them like this? What if it's on a chain? Right?
Chain could be weak too.
The chain link divide. It's gonna bounce, right? If it's moving around this much on just a shackle, imagine how much it's gonna move on a chain link chain. So you might have to twist it up before you put your halligan in there. Bring it back up. Yep. See if you can get it in there. Now that you're in. There you go. Now reset back to how you were. There you go. Straight down on it. Straight. Have you already gone?
Yeah.
Has everybody else done something? Somebody who hasn't done the axe, who's the axe? If you already did the axe. So, have you used...
I haven't used the house.
Okay.
Okay, that should go down.
Yeah.
Straight.
What? Like this right here. What's that called? This is the shaft.
Straight.
All right, I got you, bitch.
You broke away. So see that master lock that's below?
Mm-hmm.
That might be a lock that's going to be a little more difficult to get through than these.
Oh my gosh. Sorry.
Straight.
There you go. I'll use that hand for that.
I like your job, it's fun.
You can end it if you want.
No, it's fun. I'll make another one just for you.
Wait, how long is it?
Almost, I'll end it at 10.